Yeah, a couple of comeback wins against the LA Sparks should help the confidence of this Lynx team. Connecticut controls the opening tip. This is Natisha Heidemann.
Resiliency, but Coach Reed has also said we shouldn't also be getting down by double digits in the first place.
There you go. Two ways to look at it. Tiffany Hayes with the basket for Connecticut.
Tiffany Hayes has been so silky smooth joining this team for the first time this year.
Juhas picks up traffic and then gets the shot up and in. A nice move. Rebound. And we may be saying that a few times tonight. Alyssa Thomas takes contact. Was that a foul on Tiffany Mitchell? Boy, it looked like she really stood her ground. Another rebound by Thomas off the miss. She's going into the paint. Then the kick out. And another shot made by Tiffany Hayes.
They're already down an all-star in Brianna Jones. They need that front court depth that they already are missing.
Collier over Thomas for the basket. Nafisa Collier, her three-pointer. Another offensive rebound, this one by Allen. Rebecca Allen hits the three. That's the second made three-pointer. With defense by Collier. Hayes. Take the three again from the wing, and Tiffany Hayes has already hit on two three-pointers, three. Those big shots. Carlson on the bench right now. One field goal attempt in this game. Hayes, and one for Tiffany Hayes. Opportunity coming up. One of the strongest players in the league, and she uses every bit of that, too. Collier lines up a three-pointer. Beautiful shot from Fee for three.
That has been the change in
Harrington with the miss. Here's Allen. Oh, rifles the pass. What a shot to Tiffany Mitchell. Behind the back. Picks up the dribble. Nelson Adota gets it. And a clean, free look for Tiffany Hayes. And that is
one in this league.
Nelson Adota guarded by Mielich. She kicks it out. Dejanay Carrington hits the three-pointer, and that is the fifth of the game. Cheryl Reeve talked about it before the game. That is a number that really stuck with this team. And there's two paint points from Alyssa Thomas right there.
This has been a poor stretch, Marnie, only shooting 25% from three the last five games. And then they score right in the paint with the most high-efficient shot right back.
The first half, that's a lot. McBride leaves it short. Collier gets the offensive rebound and put back. Juhas hands off to McBride. Collier in the lane, up and over Thomas, rolls around and in. Nafisa Collier with consecutive baskets. Up for the rebound a little too early. Thomas, Alyssa Thomas puts a move on, goes under the basket and one opportunity on a tough hoop from Alyssa. McBride gave her that opportunity, she converted.
Especially when a free throw for her is like a layup for anyone else.
Mielich with the left hand. Nina Mielich with her
safe haven for the LGBTQ community.
Yep, honored it at center court during one of the timeouts tonight. Whoa, Nina Mielich to Nafisa Collier on a great 30 points against this Connecticut team here at Target Center 3 weeks ago. Heidemann picks it up. Gets it somehow to Hayes. Boy, Tiffany Hayes almost lost the handle. Did a good job recovering.
It's not just Alyssa Thomas who knows how to operate and distribute in tight spaces for this Connecticut offense.
Well, Mitchell blocked by Allen. Bonner has it. And outlets to Hayes. A nice. She didn't say it in that tone, though, Sloan. She said
it was a little short.
Angry and stern tone. Well, Minnesota missed on a three to open the third quarter. Biggest lead of the game for Connecticut here in the second half. McBride, who did not make a shot in the first half, hits that one there for three. That's a good. The drive, kick out to Hayes. Puts a little shimmy on Exler, goes to the hole. That's a nice drive and finish by Tiffany Hayes.
Great help defense by Rebecca Allen, too. She's stepping up big in this game, getting to start for Jones.
Heidemann drains the three-pointer. That's Natisha Heidemann's a pretty big lead for the Sun.
Still a pretty big lead, and still Minnesota has not led in this game.
Allen with the N1 opportunity. Lindsay Allen with a long Hayes. Bonner got Exler in the air, kicks it out to Hayes all alone. Tiffany Hayes has four.
as a team. Can just reiterate, last in the WNBA coming in at just 6 per game, and they don't shoot them at a good clip either.
Another and one opportunity for Lindsay Allen. This one. Milic back and forth around. Oh, what a pass. Nina Milic somehow found Nafisa Collier.
Has been playing with since Jessica Shepherd has missed the last several games due to illness.
Carrington. Oh, nice move from DeJounay Carrington underneath the rim. Collier. Allen stops, shoots, hits. Lindsay Allen has 8.
They have let teams come back, including this Lynx team, the last time they met earlier on in June when Minnesota came back to tie the game after they were down by 15. Nobody plays the game harder than her, smarter than her.
Part of USA Basketball as well, which is where Cheryl Reeve has seen Alyssa Thomas. Harris. Dribbles in, now dribbles out, now back in again. Gets it with 1 on the shot clock.
A team that started near franchise worst, 0-6 this season. But Connecticut, to me, is the top tier, cream of the crop in the WNBA right now.
The WNBA season was only these last 6 games. It'd be a totally different story for the Lynx, but it is not. But it is a long season. Juhas off the glass. 4 points. Collier hounded by the defense. Allen finds Exler. And nice. For the Sun, Minnesota still only at 6 turnovers. And maybe none in this half. I'll have to check, but they might have had 6 at halftime. Collier scores, and now
it's great to see, even when things aren't going how you want them to make those effort plays in other areas.
Exler again, the connection with Collier.
Exler is someone who's trying to find her spot in the WNBA after being a key rotation player for the Indiana Fever last year. She knows when she's on the floor, she has to make things happen and be productive.
Harrington, Connecticut shooting 43% in this game, the Lynx 28%. And Allen's shot is blocked, but Collier's there, and she finds Juhas. Collier to Juhas.
Then she leaves her former teammate at UConn, Dorka Juhas, completely open underneath. And again, they thread the needle. Allen, fantastic in the second half.
Set. Cheryl Reeve and her team. Minnesota's taking care. Oh, that's, I was just going to say taking care of the basketball. Harrington. The fast break layup after Minnesota's
upon you to be waived by the team that drafted you, to be waived once more, and then to come in and say, I'm going to do what I do. It's a really strong thing for the young players. But we're still going to be that team that's going to bully you in the paint. The calls have gone that way.
Carlton hits the 3-pointer. There it is, finally, for Bridget Carlton, who had been off the bench.
She's someone who has been a spark for them all season long, whether the game is separated like this or it's in a much closer game, but she's capable of hitting.
That one won't roll in. Exler with the offensive rebound. Bannon lines it up for 3, and it rattles around and out. David, look at the reaction from Rachel Bannon.
Sun took charge, and how to reset with the pieces that you have right now, and hopefully getting some injured pieces back and help.
A nice look underneath. That was Tyesha Harris with a nice find
in the WNBA. When it comes to talking about expanding roster,
Carrington came off the bench for Connecticut tonight. So did Harris, who just put in 2 points. Well, I'm counting it as a shot and a rebound. Maybe statistically that'll be a pass off the air ball. But a wire-to-wire win and a decisive one at that for the Connecticut Sun.